What's up? Welcome to Black Plague TV, where we promote and celebrate Rhode Island's often overlooked talent. I'm your host, Bennett Knows, and today we'll be looking at another URI student that expresses himself through dance. You may have seen Brian Lee dancing on your way to class or at the last party you were at. Brian Lee is also a member of Round Table, an on-campus entertainment group with their own radio show on WRIU, a developed clothing line, as well as the host of numerous events, including philanthropy and entertainment. In this first clip, Roundtable comes together to give viewers the Naija experience through Nigerian music, dance, and of course, some original swag. Let's check it out. This is the Naija experience. That was dope. Joining us here on Black Plague TV, Roundtable's Brian Lee. What's good, man?
Man, just chilling.
How are you?
I'm good. I'm doing good.
So bad. That was the Nyjah experience.
Yes, yes.
Tell me a little bit about the inspiration and the production in that video.
It was during the summer, like last summer, and I'm like very like culture in different cultures.
Yeah.
So I figured I'd just take a dip into like Nigerian culture, and I really liked the their dancing and their music. So I figured I'd give a little taste of like a different culture. I'm not Nigerian myself, mm-hmm. but I was like maybe I give like the audience a different taste of a different culture. So I decided to just do that for all the Nigerians out there.
I feel you. It was dope. Y'all were dancing
on
the tables, on the cars and stuff.
Yep. Thank you.
That
thank
was
you.
Pretty cool. Before we get into your dance, and let's mm-hmm. discuss Roundtable. I know what Roundtable is. You guys been around for a few years now, but let's inform the viewers of who is Roundtable and mm-hmm. exactly what it is.
Well, Roundtable consists of like me and like seven of my good friends, Robbie, Evan, Yemi, Patrick, and Joel, and obviously myself. And we're basically like an entertainment group that just hosts like different events, concerts, parties, and we just like thrive on trying to like show people, we try to give not events but experiences.
Okay.
So everything we do, we try to give somebody a new experience that they would never like actually feel before.
I feel that. Events versus experience, you know what I'm saying? So you guys had some dope events in the past.
Yeah.
I think it was Love and Hip Hop. That was one of your big events.
Mm-hmm.
You want to discuss some of these past events? And
you
guys had like special guest hosts and stuff. So let them know what's going on with y'all.
Well, we started about like throwing parties at first, like in 2011, like with Mad City. And we had Mad City, when Kendrick dropped his album, he was like, all right, let's follow his trend, Mad City. And, from there, we just threw a couple parties. We had union parties, like Keep Calm Party On. We collabed with, like, Pink and stuff to do stuff like that. There was also, we also helped promote the Bond and Pink Party, Battle of the Sexes at Tantric, which was also a dope event. And then we had also September Rush, a whole series of events during 1 month.
Yeah.
So each week we hit the campus with a different event, and then the finale was Bow Wow hosting the party at the FET.
How was that?
So that was pretty. A lot of people showed up. That was pretty dope. That turned to like almost like a mini concert. We didn't expect that, to be honest. And so that was a good show out by him and hit that crowd. That was very successful event.
Would you say that was kind of the what put y'all on the map, or?
I would say it got us higher.
Yep.
Because
kind of boosted y'all
like we was throwing the party scene for so, but that just changed the game to party scenes, because we had also like some fraternities like stepping in like during the crowd and all that. So actually that video to that party is actually out on roundtableri.com, which people could check out. And after that event, we had Erica Mena Love in December.
Which was pretty crazy, right?
Yes, her being hot off of like Love and Hip Hop, mm-hmm. we was like, I might as well bring her, because everybody was bringing, Tahiri and all that. So it's like, let's try something different.
Mm-hmm,
just brought Erica Mena out. It was crazy, because now you got Bow Wow kissing Erica Mena on 106 in Park.
Oh, yeah.
So it's like,
and
wow.
These are the two people
That we brought out. So it's like, wow. And so, and then we hope to bring many more artists in the near future. So that's to be looked out for, definitely.
Okay, so. Do you want to give us a little insight on some of these future events? I know y'all try to keep stuff down on the low.
But,
what's going on? What do you guys have planned for us this
this summer. Well, before the summer, because the summer, that's just about to be crazy.
I know.
But before the summer, we have a little something planned for like April, which I really can't announce. I would really want to announce it right now, but I really can't announce it just of yet. But it's gonna be a cool event to say the least.
All right.
Yeah, and that should be near the end of April, and it's actually like a little mini September Rush. So you'll probably expect a couple events near the end of April.
We're looking forward to that, man.
Yeah.
So you guys have your own clothing mm-hmm. brand too. This is Blase Night, correct?
Yes.
How did Blase Night, what does Blase Night even mean? You know what I'm saying?
Blase Night, I get that a lot. Some people pronounce it wrong, like, what's that, Blaze? Like, I'm like, Blase Night, so.
Okay.
But what it stands for, blasé night, basically blasé being sophistication and nonchalance. So, and night, we're the round table, so it makes sense that we're all knights. Yeah. So that's how the knight part came into it, you know? And all and both, are, you know, knights are derived from like French culture. Blasé is a French word,
yep.
So it all ties into that. And what it basically is trying to say is like, we're trying to showcase art and fashion to be sophistication, but also it doesn't always have to be that. It could be done in like a nonchalant, cool back, laid back way. Yeah. So it just incorporates both of those aspects into like art and fashion. So that's like a little bit where Blasé Night came from.
So right now you guys have shirts, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Is there anything else that you guys have? Because I know you're saying art.
Yeah.
So is there like Blasé Night art that's separate from the clothing line?
Mm-hmm.
And if there is anything coming from Blasé Night, like sweatpants, shirts.
Yes.
It's about to be summertime. You might mm-hmm. want to bring out like the bathing suits and stuff. So.
Yeah, I mean, as of now, we just have this shirt coming out, which is the Figueroa long sleeve tee.
Okay.
And that should be coming out very soon. Actually, there was we'll have a release date very soon for that.
All right.
As for art, it's basically, you know, from obviously from dancing, from actual just graphic design, from any type of art, you know, we try to showcase that. And you'll eventually see some art showcased out in the public eye,
yeah.
You know, some street art expected to be.
That's pretty dope.
Yeah,
and
so,
street art's always.
So, that, you know, like taking that Shepherd Fairey route,
okay.
You know, with the like brainwashing with the logos and all that
yeah,
stuff. So
yeah,
that should come very soon, especially when the summer gets hotter.
Yeah.
So everybody's around, they're gonna see that a lot more. So, I mean, yeah.
So, I mean, we're looking forward to that.
Definitely, good looks.
So what does round table mean to you? Like, what are they to you? Are they like family or, and how do they support, how do you like kind of incorporate your passion of dance
mm-hmm.
within the group?
Well, Roundtable means to me like a lot. Like they're basically like brothers.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That's like fam right there.
Yeah.
Like
yeah,
more like after fam, you know, is obviously a business, but
mm-hmm.
before that is, you know, we're all like brothers, and they're all supportive of like what you do. If you're really like passionate about something, they're gonna support you
yeah.
like full on, and they just like to see. Everybody likes to see each other working. Like we hate to see somebody slacking or somebody just paying too much attention to different aspects that's not
yeah.
beneficial to us and all that. And with dancing, you know, I use that as a form of expression. So if they see that I like really am passionate about it, they're gonna support it all the way. And if I could make it in dancing, they'll definitely help me do that.
That's dope. It's always nice to have like that support system, and you know they're always there for you. So
yep,
that's
definitely,
what's up.
Definitely.
So let's talk about your dancing.
Mm-hmm.
So how long have you been dancing? I know you went to classical
yeah.
and you were dancing then. So did you start in high school or was it before that? Or
yep.
what's going on?
I started sea walking in
Sea walking. What exactly is sea walking?
Sea walking is clown walking.
Okay.
And some might consider it crip walking,
okay,
but it's not crip walking.
Okay.
It's clown walking.
No spelling out crips.
No, none of that. No gang related stuff. It's just the dance art form of that and incorporated into different music. Not
right.
not really the gang related aspect
yeah.
of it, but so I was taught that by a friend of mine in 8th grade in So I started off with that. I was like, wow, this is cool. I
yep.
wanted to see what more I could do with it. And I picked it up real fast. Then after that, I got bored with it. So
yeah,
I was like,
yeah.
okay, what other dance styles can I do?
Yep.
And that's how I just keep. And then I just kept like watching a lot of YouTube videos. And eventually, I don't know, I just got like kind of nice or something. Like it just happened over time.
It just happened.
Yeah, so I've been dancing for like 6 years.
6 years.
Yeah.
So, is this just a hobby or is this something that you could see yourself doing professionally?
At the moment, it's more of a hobby, but
okay.
I definitely would like to like brand it more
mm-hmm.
and actually take it more seriously. Because
mm-hmm.
If I could dance for a living, I would definitely do that.
Yeah.
Because I really love dancing. It's like I don't care about nothing else when I do dance.
Yeah.
So it's like me being myself. So if I could really like take dancing to like the next level, I would definitely take that advantage. And, you know, I also, actually what's crazy is that I'll probably be a backup dancer for a local Rhode Island artist, Olivia King.
Yeah. Oh, that's pretty dope. She has, she just dropped her video, Lust. Mm-hmm. You check it out on BennettKnows.com.
Yep, check that out.
But that's pretty dope, man. I've always heard from dancers, like, the dance life is hard, but, mm-hmm. like, if you have that passion, yep. You could take that anywhere, you know? So that's just my advice on that.
Thanks.
So you said you catch your inspiration from cultures. We just seen that in the mm. Niger experience.
Yep.
You watch YouTube videos mm-hmm. as well. Where else do you pull your inspiration for dance?
Life. Like, just life in general. Like, walking through, like, campus or even, like, the city or whatever, you just look around and it's crazy. You see art everywhere.
Yeah.
And, like, a lot of people are, like, oblivious to it. They just have their tunnel vision. Mm-hmm. They don't look around and yeah. whatnot. But I see, like, a little something that could spark, like, an imagination, and then I'm like, oh, that's dope, you know?
Yeah.
So then I would go from there, and, like, for dancing, I just get it from, like, other dancers to be, like, I get inspired by other dancers, seeing them, and just music in general.
Yeah.
Like, you know, music is an art form as well, mm-hmm. so, like, music plays a huge role in it, whether I want to be, want to dance in, a poetic manner or, like, aggressive, like, crump manner,
yeah.
like, it depends on the music and all that. So inspiration comes from, like, legit life, like, everywhere.
Yeah, that's how you know you're a dancer. If you're just walking down the street and you see something and that inspires you,
yeah.
then you got that mentality, you know what I'm saying?
Sometimes my brain would just have a beat playing and I'll have to have the notion to move without even, like, controlling it. Like,
yeah.
I'd just be moving, like to the beat in my head, like, it's crazy.
That's the life of a dancer, you know what I'm saying?
Yep.
People just be dancing around.
Dance
stuff.
Is life.
Yeah, dance is life. So what is the hottest dance right now? Is it the nene or
oof.
Like what's going on? What do you think is the hottest dance? Or what is your favorite dance?
Favorite dance. I have so many favorite dance. Like every dance that comes out is a favorite to me because
yeah.
it's like
because you love dance.
Yeah, I love dance. Life. But I would say the hardest at the moment would probably be the nene. But what's coming up is this thing called the yeet.
The yeet?
Yeah, yeet.
The yeet?
Yeah, yeet.
What's the yeet?
Y-E-E-T. It's on Worldstar. Like, a lot
okay.
of people on Worldstar are doing it. It's just they're going crazy and then they really just yeet.
Yeet.
Yeet. Yep. And every time they yeet, so it's like, I mean, I just saw it and I was like, hey, whatever. If you play a song that I could do a yeet to, I will do it. You
yeah,
know what
yeah.
I'm saying?
So are we going to see some yeet during this performance we're about to have?
We'll probably see some yeet or some Dougie or some Nene. We'll probably incorporate all of it.
Definitely got to incorporate that.
You know, like real quick.
It's hot. I went home, my little sisters were doing the Nene. My little sister's six.
It's crazy. That's crazy.
That's
how global dances.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? It's all over the place now. J-Lo's doing it. I just seen Ryan Seacrest post a video. He's obsessed with Nene. You would never think that, you know?
Yep.
But I got one more question for
mm-hmm.
you. I already told you what it was.
Yeah.
Who are the best dancers on URI's campus right now?
Damn.
You only could pick. I don't want you to pick everybody. I'll give you three. Three people.
Three people? Can I pick myself?
Yeah.
All right. So I'm going to just put myself out
okay.
there for one. Just, you know, you have to be that person in dance if you want to be the best.
Brian
but, Lee. So, I'd also give it to, let me see. Like, I really don't know a lot of dancers too much, but I know, I'll give it Toye.
Toye.
I'll shout out Toye real quick. And, a real good girl dancer, which a lot of people might not know, is Bethany.
Okay, yeah.
You know, she's a freshman. She's a very good dancer. So
yeah.
I give her that, too. So I'll give you those three right there.
All
right,
so Brian Lee, Toye, and Bethany, three best dancers on this campus, as told by Brian Lee. All right, so right now, we are going to watch a video
mm-hmm.
Directed by James Zong. This is Brian Lee dancing to Rico Loves,
yep.
They Don't Know. Check it out.
They don't know, they don't know. We be in the same room, we gon' never say shit. Just keep it between me and you, and we cool, 'cause they don't know.
I'm the one you be texting when you be up at your job. I'm the one that bought that Benz to sing your garage. I'm the reason you don't stress when shit gets hard. And anything you want is all yours. On your birthday, I'm the one who saw your birthday suit. Got the Birkin bag and bought that birthday coupe. Keep it all real, I ain't gotta tell lies to you. You're the only one who knows the truth.
They don't know, they don't know. They don't know, they don't know. They don't know, they don't know. They don't know.
We be in the same room, we don't never say shit. Just keep it between me and you, and we cool, cause they don't know.
They don't know.
Freestyling to Diamonds, Blaze Up, URI's best dancer, and Roundtable's Brian Lee. Check it out. Good man, that was dope. Had me on the sidelines, acting like I knew how to nay nay and stuff. But for updates on Roundtable's projects, check out Roundtable on their official site, roundtablert.com. Be sure to listen to Roundtable Radio on Tuesday nights from 12 a.m. to 3 a.m. on 90.3 FM. For the latest news on your favorite music, celebrities, and local talent, make sure you check out BennettKnows.com. Thank you for watching, and join us next week when we showcase another one of Rhode Island's often overlooked talent. Until next time, I'm Bennett Knows, and this is Black Plague TV.